As developer of the popular Peace Equalizer interface, I've helped many people to install Equalizer APO. Most of the time, this piece of software which is crucial for the operation of Peace Equalizer installed without issues. But occasionally it doesn't install or you get stuck at some point not knowing what to do next. This tutorial explains what you might do to solve Equalizer APO installation issues. But first, I'll clear up some major confusions. After installing Equalizer APO on your computer, you might think you're done, especially when Equalizer APO, thus Peace, works on your speaker's output. But there's more to it. At the installation process of Equalizer APO, two things happen. First, the audio processing engine and the software is installed on your computer. Second, Equalizer APO is activated on your default speaker's output and your default microphone output, not on any other audio device like your USB headset or your Bluetooth headphones. Let me say this again. Equalizer APO isn't activated on devices like USB and Bluetooth headphones, nor on USB and Bluetooth microphones. Besides, this activation isn't called that way, it's called installation, creating a confusion of what installing Equalizer APO actually means. So where can the initial installation, the installation of the audio processing engine and the other Equalizer APO software, go wrong? First, by not running the setup program or other Equalizer APO programs for that matter, with administrative rights. Not doing so may prevent a proper installation of Equalizer APO. Second, antivirus software may prevent installation of software in the first place. It doesn't happen a lot, but I've seen Equalizer APO sandbox, meaning it isn't installed in the correct program folder, rather in some sandbox folder. Obviously, this prevents Equalizer APO from working. Also, I've seen that only some parts of Equalizer APO were installed instead of everything. But a simple check can be done to resolve this. Just go to the folder, see program files, Equalizer APO, to see if there are files, especially the equalizerapo.dll file, which is the audio engine. Also check the subfolder called config. There should be a file called config.txt, which is vital for operation. Notice if you're using a 30-bit version of Windows, Equalizer APO is installed in C program files x86 Equalizer APO. At the end of the installation of Equalizer APO, its configurator pops up. With this app, you activate, installed as it's called, Equalizer APO onto the audio devices you want the audio to change by using Peace. You'll notice that Equalizer APO is installed on the default speaker's output. You also notice there are two tabs, one called Playback, the other Capture. Again, confusing, but consider playback as the output of your computer, like a 3.5-inch jacks, HDMI or USB. And capture is just the input, like a 3.5-inch or USB microphone. When you look at the Capture tab, you'll see that the default microphone has Equalizer APO installed on it. This might be the built-in mic of your laptop. Say you have decided to buy a gaming headset. You plug it in and think you can change its audio by Peace. This isn't the case, as mentioned before. First, you need to install and activate Equalizer APO on the headphones part and on the microphone part of the headset. Then you can select it in Peace to change it. After installing Equalizer APO on a device and restarting your computer, you should see the message APO already installed in the column at the right of that device in the configurator. If not, then something went wrong. This might happen for several reasons, mainly because an antivirus app is preventing the configurator to write to the audio device's keys in the Windows registry. This is needed to reroute the audio stream from the audio device through the audio processing engine of Equalizer APO. Without this rerouting, Peace can't work as Equalizer APO doesn't have access to the audio stream. Usually antivirus software doesn't prevent this rerouting, but it may happen. Talking about rerouting the audio stream, any Windows update might undo this rerouting. Therefore, Peace is monitoring if Windows has been updated. If so, it shows this in a pop-up message. As many of us are now using Windows 10, you might think that the configurator is detecting this. But you're wrong. By default, when installing Equalizer APO on an audio device, it uses the former Windows 7 LFX GFX way of doing audio processing objects, which are the audio enhancements of a device, things like automatic leveling or some surround sound effect. This LFX GFX option is even set as recommended, but that's faulty on Windows 10, as this version uses two different techniques called SFX MFX and SFX EFX. The latter is the one that gets Equalizer APO usually working on the device on Windows 10. It doesn't say that LFX GFX can't work, as it could be included in the device software. The question is for how long, as any update may remove this option. So how do you access these options I'm talking about? Again, this is a bit confusing, so let me guide you through that process. First of all, determine the target device on which to install Equalizer APO and install it by checking the left checkbox of that device. After a computer restart, it should say APO already installed in the configurator for that device. Then check if it works by starting PEACE, selecting this device in PEACE and in Windows, playing some song on it, and influence its gain, say volume, by moving the upper pre-amplifying slider to the left and right. If this works, you're done. If it doesn't, start the configuration of Equalizer APO. Now you're going to set the FFX EFX option for that device. This option is a setting of the so-called troubleshooting options. To access those, click on the name of the device in the left connector column. The device name should now be in white on blue background. Then check the troubleshooting options checkbox and select SFX EFX from the Install As drop-down box at the right. After a computer restart, do the pre-amplifying trick as mentioned earlier. Note that any change in the configurator needs to follow with a computer restart to invoke the change. Besides SFX EFX, you might try SFX MFX. Sometimes this also gets Equalizer APO going on a device. Another tip is to uninstall the software that came with the headset or headphones. Often this software is quite crappy and you have PEACE to equalize and do effects anyway. Uninstalling this software means that Windows after a restart usually installs a standard device driver, which is almost always compatible with Equalizer APO. But even then, the SFX EFX or the SFX MFX setting must be set in most occasions. The last setting to try of the troubleshooting options are the Use Original APO checkboxes. You might lose some audio enhancements of a device, but you gain all the PEACE features. As these are two checkboxes, start by unchecking the pre-mix one, then try unchecking the post-mix one. Of course, any setting change needs a computer restart.